Our response to the Holocaust involves justice, absolutely. But justice is universal, and it's a phenomenon of every crime. It has nothing specifically to do with the Holocaust. What interests me is something quite different, and that is what I call tikkun. Tikkun is a Jewish mystical concept developed by Isaac Luria in the 16th century, which speaks about mending the tears in the fabric of creation. And in the case of the Holocaust, three individuals speak to me very, very much. Number one was the Lubavitcher Rebbe, Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, whom I knew. He was the first Jew ever, really, to engage in outreach, to reach out to Jews who had been distant from the tradition in the most remote places. He did this all over the world. He never explained why. I mean, why had it never been done before? And why was he the first to do it? And of course, it would have changed every Jewish community in the world. And I once suggested this. He had lived through the Holocaust. And he had seen hate for hatred's sake. And he was a mystic. And he did believe in tikkun. And therefore, I believe that what he was doing is reaching out to every Jew in love, as once the Nazis searched out every Jew in hate. That was his tikkun. And as I say, it changed the whole tenor of the Jewish world. The second was an extraordinary story which I was unaware of until the London Olympics of 2012. And it was then the BBC showed a very moving film about somebody I'd never heard of before, Dr. Ludwig Guttmann. Dr. Guttmann was in 1933 the leading neurosurgeon in Germany. But in 1933, Jews were removed from all the professions. He was thrown out of the hospital. He was able to work for the next 5 years in a Jewish hospital, but then in 1938, it just became too dangerous for him, and he left and he came to London. Realizing the genius they had in their midst, the British government asked him in 1944 to set up the first ever dedicated unit for the treatment of paraplegics, which he did. And he was horrified by what he saw, because these paraplegics, all suffering war injuries, were young people, 20, 21 years old, and their life expectancy was between 3 and 6 months. They were being kept heavily sedated, horizontal in hospital beds. And he realized there was no need for this. These were young men who had a life in front of them. And he set about giving them new life. And it was very difficult. The first thing he did was reduce their sedation, their painkillers, which hurt. Then he started throwing balls at them so they would catch them, and that hurt. And then he got them out of their beds into wheelchairs, and that hurt. And the doctors accused him of cruelty. And he took him to a tribunal, and one of his fellow doctors said, "Who do you think these men are? They are moribund cripples." And he said, "Who do I think they are? The best of men." Eventually, he got them out into the garden, playing games, and he put the doctors and nurses into wheelchairs. And the paraplegics, because they were used to wheelchairs, beat the doctors. And he gave them, for the first time, a sign of life. So he began to organize more competitions, and then not just national, but international. And then he started, I think it was 1948, a parallel Olympics. And of course, by the time 2012 came along, they were there from 140 different countries, 4,000 of them. And the whole attitude of the world to them and them to themselves had changed. And I wondered, what was it about a Jewish doctor that took a Jewish doctor from Germany to see what nobody in Britain could see? And then I realized, it's obvious, because he was a man the Germans regarded as subhuman, vermin, lice. And he knew he wasn't subhuman. And he looked at these paraplegics and realized they weren't subhuman either. And that was his taking his pain to cure the pain of others and give them new hope and new life. That was a tikkun. And finally, I think of the Klausenberger Rav, the rabbi of Klausenberg, who lost all his family in the Holocaust and vowed that if he survived, having seen a whole culture of death, he would do what he could to save life. And he built the Laniado Hospital in Netanya, dedicated to curing people of all religions and all races, and bringing life where once was death. Those are the real responses to the Holocaust. And I find them very moving.